Okay, so we've done his head. We've worn up our markers for this area. Base of the skull, top of the scapula. And we're going to be working on basically the front of the thoracic limb into his neck and throat area, or into his throat area here. The neck is all on the top line, right? And then the top of his chest here, we're going to do a little bit of work on too.
Okay, so before we get started, just a reminder, if you haven't seen the strokes and how to apply them video, please take a look at that now before you do any massaging on your dog. The first stroke we're going to be doing on the neck area is called jostling or kneading. Very simple stroke, really, really effective for getting everything warmed up. And all we're doing is we're working in a straight line from the base of the skull to the front of the scapula, back and forth. Depending on the size of your dog, you can use two hands, one hand, a couple of fingers. Just make sure that you're pulling the fascia up and just letting it drop. Then we're going to do our first round of compression. Again, we're going to be working on the same area that we were jostling and just going in a straight line back and forth. We're going to do light first, then medium, and then we can do a little bit of heavy pressure if the dog allows us. First round of compression done, we're then going to start some thumb palpation of the same area. Base of the skull to the top of the scapula. Make sure your thumb is applying downward pressure. Again, starting light, then going medium, and then to heavy. And remember, stop at the front of the scapula. There's no need to go any further. Next up, we're going to just go a little bit closer into the spine. Never on the spine, always work a little bit off it. And we're just going to be doing some fingertip jostling of the area. This is great for getting those spinal nerves and neurons all firing up for everything that we're going to be doing. Next up, we're going to start some percussion. Now look at where my hand is. I'm in line with the dog's body. I'm not going opposite to it. I'm in line with it. And again, I'm just going back and forth with a nice loose wrist, starting light and building up pressure as we go. Then we're going to do a little bit more compression just because it's always nice to compress an area after it's been percussed, spreading the fibers, getting some oxygen blood into the area. Easy peasy. Then we're going to do a stroke called zigzag. What zigzag strokes do is it hits the muscle fibers in a different way than what we've been doing. We've been doing strokes along the muscle fibers. Now we're going to go across the muscle fibers. Same area, back and forth, straight line. Then finally, to finish off the area, we're going to do a little bit more compression before we flip him over and then start working on his chest area. Okay, he's flipped over so you can see what I'm doing. And all I'm doing here is I'm following the natural curve of his skull from his ear all the way down, and I'm thumb palpating. Now, there's some really important lymph nodes in this area, so this is great to massage. We're then going to do the same exact stroke, just further down into the chest. So we're going to start at the scapula up the top, which you can easily feel for, and just follow the natural curvature of the limb, palpating all the way down and through. Here, I'm applying some direct pressure into a depression in the area, and you can see they're going to react straight away, which tells me that I'm hitting some really nice nerves. You can do this for 10 seconds, 20 seconds, as long as the dog will let you do it. Then we're going to do some flat hand percussion from side to side, working both of the pecs. Again, we're going to start light and we're going to go left, right, just across and back as many times as we want. Gunner seems to be liking it, so I can do it a little bit more. Oh, he heard me. And then final stroke in the area, we're going to be doing some circular friction. Now remember, there's two ways that we can do this. I'm doing continuous circles. Again, just working the whole area. We don't need to go any further behind their elbow because that's a separate section. And we can do this for as long as we want. A great way to finish off the area. Lots of lovely muscles to work on and a happy dog.
Hi! Hi! Hi!
Hi.